Welcome to Car Comparers. Today we'll be comparing the Tata Hexa versus the Mahindra Scorpio. Pricing and features. Hexa XM 4x2 manual costs 16.5 lakh rupees on road Delhi, which is 1.5 lakh rupees more expensive than Scorpio's top of the line S10 4x2 manual variant costing 15 lakh. In spite of being cheaper, the Scorpio S10 has a long list of extra features over the Hexa XM, like automatic climate control, cornering lamps, tire pressure monitoring system, cruise control, automatic rain sensing wipers, light sensing headlamps, fog lamps, alloy wheels, and LED DRLs. The Hexa, on the other hand, has only two extra features over the Scorpio, which are retractable window sunblinds and heated mirrors. Performance and drivability. The Hexa looks quite impressive on paper, but in the real world, there is hardly any difference in performance of these two mini trucks. The Hexa is barely half a second quicker than the Scorpio in the 0-100 sprint. In terms of drivability, the Scorpio is in fact much better than the Hexa. Scorpio's turbocharger spools up almost 1000 revs earlier, requiring far less gear shifting while driving around town. Both cars are fairly equal in terms of refinement. Amongst the automatics, it's the Hexa which thoroughly impresses with its smooth shifts and responsive nature compared to the relatively slow and lazy transmission of the automatic Scorpio. Fuel efficiency. In our back-to-back tests, the manual Scorpio was consistently 1 kmpl more efficient than the Hexa, whereas there was hardly any difference in the fuel efficiency of the automatic versions. Resale and cost of ownership. 2011 model year Scorpios retail for around 7 lakh rupees in the used car market. The facelifted version is bound to retain slightly better residual value than that. The Hexa 2 is bound to retain better value than what the Ariya does in the market today. Overall though, the Scorpio S10 works out to be 2.5 lakh rupees cheaper than the Hexa XM in terms of overall ownership costs. Space and comfort. The Scorpio is no match to the Hexa in terms of interior space and ergonomics. Even though the Hexa XM does not offer the option of captain seats like the XT variant, its middle bench has more than adequate room in all possible directions for seating 3 full-sized adults. Scorpio S10 comes with the option of captain seats, but they are woefully short on knee room and leg room. Hexa's third row is just adequate for 2 adults. Scorpio is available with an option of a forward-facing third row, which is tolerable only for the smallest members of your family, while the sideways-facing third row seats are not even suitable for the children. But that's not all. Even with all the seats up, the Hexa has a hatchback-sized boot space left over at the rear, whereas the Scorpio has absolutely no room left for luggage when all the seats are occupied. Handling and ride quality. There is a world of difference in the way these two cars tackle rough roads. The Scorpio looks like it can plow through bumps and ruts without even taking your foot off the accelerator. But if you actually do that, it will throw around the passengers until their bones turn to powder. The Hexa, on the other hand, has been tuned just right for Indian roads. It effortlessly dismisses roads bad enough to break some cars in half. It arguably has the best ride quality of any car in the Indian market this side of an S-Class. Neither of these cars were meant to tackle corners. That being said, the Hexa corners surprisingly flat given its height and even has a fairly precise and well-weighted steering setup. Scorpio, on the other hand, is so bad at cornering that it is downright scary to throw her around the bends. Steering is way too light for highway duty and requires constant correction at highway speeds. Reliability and after-sale service. Both Mahindra and Tata Motors sail in the same boat when it comes to the inherent lack of reliability of their products. They still have a long way to go before they catch up to competitors from the land of the rising sun. However, the current Scorpio has been around since 2014 and thus is bound to face lesser teething troubles than the Hexa. Mahindra also has comparatively better grip on their dealers and has taken the efforts to whip them up in shape. Tata Motors, however, continues to look the other way when it comes to the state of affairs at their touch points. Which brings us to the verdict. The Scorpio is a product that is way past its expiration date. Firstly, it is not a comfortable vehicle even for 5 people due to its tight middle row. Calling it a 7-seater is downright deception. The bouncy ride makes it a total nightmare for everyone except the front two occupants. Secondly, it has one of the most flawed dynamics of any car available in the market today. It rolls like a yacht and utterly lacks the composure and confidence around sweeping bends or even during high-speed cruising. Thirdly, even after all these years, it continues to be a fairly unreliable vehicle. Suffering through all these major shortcomings in the interest of saving a couple of lakhs over the Hexa would be a terrible decision, which is why the Hexa, being the lesser of the two devils, is our pick of this shootout.